Okay, so the purpose of this video is to show you how to use Google Calendar, and more specifically Google Calendar in G Suite. So you can see I'm logged into my G Suite account in the upper right hand corner. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go down in the lower left hand corner and look at what calendars I can see and what that means. So first we're going to left click on the arrow next to My Calendars, and these calendars are within G Suite. So they're within the organization. I have my own calendar. So if I left click, put a check mark here, you're going to see my events. And we're going to get into the details of all of these. These are some different types of things that you can do in with your G Suite calendar. But I'm going to turn that back off. And there's some different things here as well. So there's a projector and a conference room. And then I put in some coworkers. All right, so this is a coworker. Turn that calendar on and off. And this is one also. And so all of the calendars under My Calendars are ones that you have access to at a higher level than just a public calendar. But if we look at the other calendars, expand this, we'll contract My Calendars, expand this. There's two examples here. One is just say holidays. Okay, this is a public calendar. You need the URL to subscribe to it. I can't add things to it, but it will show in my G Suite calendar. So if I go to next week, you're going to see Martin Luther King Day on here. And that's, notice, the same color as the check mark here. So it corresponds to the color of the calendar. I can open it up. It's going to tell me what calendar it's coming from. Yeah, but it's locked down. It's a public calendar. Okay, so I'm not going to click on this, but if I did, it would bring up all of my personal appointments. I'm going to turn off the holidays, and I'm going to go back to My Calendars. All right, so I've gone back to the present week, and I'm going to click on just My Main Calendar. And you can see it's surrounded in red here, and it indicates all of the events, reminders, etc. in that same color. So if I were to open up Millard's calendar, you're going to be able to tell that these events are his because they're color-coded. Now we're going to click into some of these to explain a few things that are going on. So you notice this lunch, I scheduled this with Millard, but Millard has a yellow calendar, but the colors are inverted on this, so the background's white. That means that he hasn't accepted it yet. So if you see that, yeah, you might want to call him, right? Make sure your lunch is on. Let me open it up. And I'm going to click on the pencil to look at the details. We're going to talk about a few things that are going on here. And all of these enhancements are available, like I said, in G Suite. And if you don't have it yet, there is a 20% off discount that you can get. If you email me, I'll give you a unique code that you can apply for your first year. So check that out if you're interested. One is the ability to find a time. That's not going to be in your personal Google Calendar, but it is in G Suite. And I can look at Millard's available time. So he's not available from 12:30 to 1:30, but otherwise he is. And if you scroll down further, you can tell something that I have going on my calendar on the left is that I've defined office hours and they end at 5. So you're going to see the suggestion of this being grayed out because I have set that. They're not set for Millard, but they are for me. So if I go up here as well, you can see that in my admin settings in G Suite, I said I don't start until 9 a.m. That doesn't prevent things from being put in those times, but it gives you the suggestion when you're looking for times. We're going to go back to the event details. Another thing that is different in G Suite is that if you do a video call, the option it's going to give you is Hangouts Meet, not just Hangouts. So Meet is the enterprise option. It gives you a cleaner interface. It's mostly just a video. Here you can see it's my calendar. I can actually change this to these other calendars because in the admin settings, I've said, hey, I need to be able to edit everyone's calendar. So I can actually work on behalf of Millard or Nelly, and I can book appointments for them. You can turn that on or off. And another thing that's available here is the ability to book rooms through it. And as you saw before, I did set up a conference room. So let's just left click on that. And that's been added. So when I click save, it's asking me if I want to send an email to update the guest. We just won't do that for now. We'll come back and we were looking at lunch, right? And if I bring up this conference room calendar, it's going to show the lunches also in there, and it automatically accepted it. So I'm going to turn off these other calendars for now to give us a cleaner interface. And we're going to look at some of the other types of events. So if you left click, you're going to see events, but you're also going to see out of office and appointment slots. You would also see a reminder if I had that calendar checked in the lower left-hand corner, but I don't have it on right now. So out of office is just to block out some time. That's what I've done right here. So when other people go to schedule meetings with me, they'll see that I'm not available. And visitation hours are something unique. So if you put these in here, that's telling Google Calendar from 2 to 3:30, someone can come in and book an appointment with you. But left click on this, you can go to this link. It's going to bring you to another view. This contains my visitation hours. And if I click on one of these, I can book an appointment with myself, with Adam. All right, so if you're a professor or someone else that has office hours, that can come in handy. Okay, I'm gonna go and add reminders back on, and I'm going to left click in a slot, and you see now I have the option for a reminder, but you can do that in the regular Google Calendar as well. So I'm gonna assume that you're familiar with those. I'm gonna turn that back off. Now I've set up three employees. I have myself and I have these two other people. Something else I've done, it's kind of behind the scenes, I'll show it to you, but you can't see it very well on the calendar, is I've defined groups. So I've put myself and one other person in marketing, and I put myself and one other person in accounting, but they're different people. So you can define groups of anyone you want, and one person can be in more than one group, and you can schedule appointments with the group. So if I left click here and I go to more options for the details and I add a guest, if I type in marketing, the name of that group is going to come up. Okay, so that's going to send it to everyone in that group. I'm going to back out of this, and I'm going to show you where I did that. If we're looking at the main Google Admin console here, I just find it easier to left click in the hamburger menu in the upper left hand corner and go to directory and just look at groups. This is where you can set them up and move people in and out of them. The next thing that you can do that we touched on a little bit is to define resources. So if you go to buildings and resources, you have to set up a building first and then you can manage resources. This is where I made a projector. So if you have an expensive projector, so you only have one of them and you have to reserve it, you would set something like that up in here. And obviously you could do meeting rooms in here as well, so you can book time in them. Do anything you want. We go to add one, you're going to see that they have a lot of options, right? You can define the floor that it's on, the building, the floor section. These are way beyond anything that I would do, but the point is that you have the flexibility of having them here. They're not required, so you can use them if you want to. Okay, and I also brought my phone up on the screen just to show you that basically all of this functionality also flows through into your phone. I have the Android Google Calendar app, and these were the events that we were just looking at. You can also left click in the upper left hand corner. So this is where you would subscribe and unsubscribe to different calendars. If I go into the settings and I choose show more, you'll see all of the calendars that we were just looking at are shown here, and I could subscribe to them if I wanted to. If you want to see an overall comparison of G Suite to all of the free Google apps, check out this video that I'm linking to. And that's about all. So if you like this video, you can please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner and you'll see more just like this one. Thanks.